Thank you. Tito!
Get going!
Thanks.
For what? It's my boat I was looking after. Not you.
That figures.
We're not out of it yet.
You can't outrun them.
I can outdodge them. Hang on.
I owe you as a drink.
Forget it. Wait a minute. I'll take that drink if you're still offering. Danny Mancini.
Cliff Wilder.
It, risking your life to get a few pictures of red Chinese and losing your gear.
French magazine thinks it's worth it. At least they agreed to pay my price.
You sound expensive.
Well, I don't figure you were dodging around the border for $1 an hour.
Whiskey? 2 whiskeys. Have you ever relaxed in this town before?
Once or twice, why?
There's a place called the Café aux Fans. Ask for Madame Volcano. Tell her I sent you.
I might do that. Where do you go? Home to mother?
I'm not married.
What's the matter?
Where you staying?
Hotel Paloma, why?
Hang on to this for just a few hours. Don't tell anybody you've got it, understand?
Oh, buddy, the last time I saw you, you running for your life in Red China. Before we play games, I want to know whose side you're
on. My side.
Thank you.
door was open.
No, it wasn't.
Well, I knocked, but you probably couldn't hear in the bath. I knew you were here, so I asked the porter to let me in.
Does everyone around here usually do what you ask?
You came ashore with Danny Mancini today.
So?
I'm Lily Mancini.
Oh, his sister?
No, his wife.
I see.
He gave you a package and asked me to get it.
Package? You must have got the message wrong.
Mr. Wilder, I do appreciate your caution. But let me assure you that...
You don't want to assure me, Mrs. Mancini. Hotel porters let you know the people's rooms, and I'm sure someone down at that waterfront bar gave you some information. Those kind of friends aren't always reliable.
Danny said...
Danny said what? That my boat ran out of gas and he gave me a lift back to shore, so what?
He told me all that, but...
I don't know why he should. It's not true. He didn't send you here, and you're not his wife. Want to start again? Where is Danny?
Let me go.
Go where?
And if I scream?
Then what, the police? You came in here uninvited carrying a gun. Go ahead, scream. Damn shame you're so tricky.
Welcome to the Cafe of France, where you can dine, dream, play cards, or be incredibly naughty. You look molto simpatico. What can I get you?
Well, a drink.
Oh, immediately. The first is in the house. Can I get you? A magnificent blonde. Simply magnificent. Rosemary. Astonishingly versatile. A very good family. Oh! Excuse me. Her father was a film producer. Elga. A little bit strict, perhaps, but very patient. No.
No.
But the whole of this world is your oyster.
I'm waiting for a man.
Oh, Burke! Trust me!
waiting for you. Warehouse 10, K13.
Where is he? Danny Mancini, where is he?
He didn't turn up?
No, he didn't turn up. But don't worry, I wasn't lonely. I had company.
You got into a fight?
I got out of a fight. Now, go on, call him up. Get him in here.
I don't know where he is.
You tell him from me I don't like it. Especially I don't like it because I didn't ask to play. You tell him I don't like being a patsy.
Sit down. Sit.
Thanks.
You'd like a drink?
Why not?
Have another one. I get lonely. Danny leaves me alone too much. No one can disturb us now. I don't get many visitors.
Oh, come now.
Well, not many visitors I'd like to know better.
The least I can do is help restore your confidence.
Well, I don't want you to get involved. I know you're keeping a package for Danny. Give it to me. I'll see that he gets it.
Anything you say.
Where is it?
We can talk later.
Do you have the package?
No, I gave it to someone.
Who?
I gave it to Madame Vulcano.
Who?
Madame Vulcano. You see, she's also lonely and doesn't get many visitors.
You are an idiot.
And you're fickle. I'm sure glad I found out in time.
Get out of here!
Well, you can't win them all.
Pray stay just where you are, dear sir. And do not be alarmed. As you can see, my appearance is benevolent. Definitely benevolent. My name is Pinto. Francis Pinto. Oh, clearly you are a stranger here. I detected no flicker of recognition when you heard my name.
Have you finished?
Finished? I'm never finished. I'm by nature a garrulous man.
That's fine. You can talk all the way down.
Down?
The stairs.
Oh, I fear I did not introduce myself properly.
A cop?
Rather more than that. A king cop, chief of police. You'll please come with me.
Am I under arrest?
If necessary. Is it? You have seen these men before? Oh, come now. We know you were in this area.
They jumped me.
And you killed them?
No.
Then who did?
I don't know. I never saw him before.
A good Samaritan. Just happened to be driving along a stretch that doesn't lead anywhere. Just happened to be carrying a loaded gun and in need of target practice. Would you think incredible too strong an adjective?
It's a truth.
Very well. Let us accept it as the truth for the moment. What were you doing here in the first place?
Came here to meet a man named Danny Mancini.
Who said you'd meet him here?
A girl, a stripper. She works at the Cafe of Fans.
Dark and nubile, very pretty.
Yes.
That would be Jasmine. Splendid creature. Why did she send you here?
Why not ask her?
We shall, immediately. Yes, splendid creature, Jasmine. Although I always thought I'm just a little too fat in the thigh. Morning.
You are trailing us. You definitely promised. You give me at least 12 hours clear warning.
This is not a raid, dear lady.
Oh, I see. We are closed. But in your case...
We just came to see Jasmine.
Oh, bene, bene. Open again tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock.
In the morning?
We like to catch the early rise.
Becoming a condition that follows you, Mr. Wilder. Shambles. Completely ransacked. Could they have been looking for something, Mr. Wilder?
Danny Mancini, he's the one you should be talking to.
Oh, Danny Mancini, well, why didn't you say so before? I'll take you to him right away. That's a pity. Apart from her thighs, he was quite perfect. You'll find Mancini up there.
Aren't you coming?
I've finished with him.
Things a bit.
They pulled him out of the harbor last night.
Drowned?
Burned. Someone used a blowtorch on him.
Just someone?
I thought you'd know.
Why me?
You're still alive.
So far.
Danny wasn't much. He'd other women, I know, but I'm his only widow. We weren't married long, and that was some time ago. But we were married.
That's still not why you're here. Look, you don't like me, and I'm not crazy about you, so we can afford to tell each other the truth.
The truth is that he was a frightened man, but I didn't find that out until later.
What happened in between?
He put me to work so he could live off me, and when he thought he could do better, he walked out.
Did he do better?
You tell me. He left last week saying he had his first chance to cash in big.
And if he did cash in big, you feel he owes you something.
Yes, he owes me. He never had anything to give. And if money's the only thing I can take, I'll take that.
Dead or alive?
That's right. Dead or alive. You asked for the truth.
That I did.
If Danny gave you anything, I have the right to share it.
Maybe you do. Maybe Danny did owe you something, but I can't pay his debts for him.
All right. But he tried to go it alone, and you see what happened.
Is that a threat?
I don't think so.
Don't tell me you're worried about me.
Ah, finished paying your last respects? Excellent. We'll go back to my office. Talk things over. And we'll have you searched. Sad to say, clean, Mr. Wilder.
Sad to say?
We'll talk. That's better. Can't stand cats, especially fluffy ones. They always make me want to sneeze. Say when. If you're worried about drinking before sundown, always close the shutters.
What were you hoping to find? A search. What was that all about?
I would like to be rich, Mr. Wilder. Not in a subtle, unostentatious way, but filthy rich. Vulgar, decadent affluence. That's my dream. I have a feeling for it. My paintings, my trivia, all muck, all imitation. But they betray my taste for the finer things. I believe I was born for the trappings of great luxury, Mr. Wilder. But so far, I've been cursed with the wrong set of trappings. I was looking for a medallion, Mr. Wilder. A small thing, so big, with a twin dragon carved upon it. It had been lost for 2,000 years, and then recently, there came reports that it had turned up again. On the other side, in Red China.
And then he went in and got it.
Of course. That's why he was murdered. There are other interested parties.
For instance.
Marvelous. I bring you here and you try to get information out of me. You're an amusing devil, sir.
Who killed Danny Mancini?
The Fusong or Joey Brandon?
Joey Brandon's a name. The other sounds like a cure for a hangover.
I assure you, the cure, nothing. Except perhaps a desire to go on living. The Fusong is a Chinese tong as old as history itself. Joe Brandon is the local leader of an American gambling syndicate, and between them, they control all that is dark and dirty in our charming little community.
Not everything.
How do you mean?
You're being too modest. This medallion, what makes it so special?
Very well. And if the time comes, remember it was I who was gracious enough to tell you.
Cross my heart.
Well, the medallion holds the key to an ancient treasure worth... the sum is too staggering for anyone to be sure. 5 million? 10?
Go
Kwan.
It is a historical fact that an emperor of the Third Dynasty was buried here. It is also a fact that his crown, jewels, and scepter were buried with him. The scepter so encrusted with emeralds that no gold could be seen. The crown so heavy that no mortal man could ever wear it, a symbol of wealth and power. Rubies, diamonds, sapphires, and the smallest as big as a man's fist.
Cheers.
My troubles are over, and yours aren't, even if you don't have the medallion. They think you do.
Any they in particular?
That lot back there.
Are they Fu Sung or Joey Brent?
One of each.
Well, they'll just have to split me up the middle.
They might just do that. Joey Brandon's place. I work for him.
Hotel Paloma.
How do you do, Mr. Wilder?
How do you do?
My name is Chow, Jonathan Chow.
That's your problem.
This is a sample of your work, I believe.
Those were the days.
My mistress desires that you photograph her at her home. Your price?
$500 an hour.
Very reasonable. We will call for you in 30 minutes.
Hey, wait a minute. I forgot. I haven't got any equipment.
Oh, no problem.
Thank you.
lady of the house will be along immediately.
The equipment?
It is all arranged.
Didn't tell me you were so handsome.
Not everyone agrees.
Am I what you expected?
I expected more muscles and not as well arranged.
I'm afraid I don't understand. You see, my English is not very good.
Your English is just gorgeous.
Well then, how do we begin?
It's your $500 an hour.
Do you consider that excessive?
Depends on what I have to do for it.
Well, take my picture.
Well, that is ridiculous.
Perhaps you'd like to be paid in advance.
A small down payment might do.
I'm not carrying any money.
That's obvious, I'm happy to say. There are all kinds of legal tender.
What are you doing?
You know what I'm doing. The point is, how am I doing?
Let me help you.
You're doing fine.
No, I'm serious. Joey Brandon wants to kill you.
I wonder why.
You know why.
Yes, and so do you.
You realize you could have made love to me before admitting you were suspicious.
Yes, I know. I have a big mouth.
Yes. You're very attractive.
What am I supposed to say? Not a nice girl like you get mixed up with a bunch of cutthroats like the Fu Song?
You know that, too.
I always was good at arithmetic.
Very well. But by being here, you might be in danger.
Maybe. Of course, I could put both hands around your lovely neck and let you walk me safely out of here.
Go ahead. Go on, squeeze. If you're willing to share your reward, I'm willing to share your risk. We could share everything, even each other.
You're good. Oh, you're very good. I keep thinking you must have made the same offer to Danny Mancini. Did I say something?
member of our staff who displeased us.
He made a mistake, and now he must suffer for it.
Nobody disobeys the Frusong. You don't display much curiosity, Mr. Wilder. You don't even ask what mistake that unfortunate man made. He was impetuous. He very stupidly killed a man before he had been made to talk.
He killed Danny Mancini. We are not animals, Mr. Wilder. We get no pleasure from inflicting pain.
But we do use it. We will use it against you if necessary.
I see I've come at an opportune moment. Trouble with the servants again? I promised I'd give you a lift back to the hotel, isn't that right?
Definitely.
Unless I'm disturbing you.
Oh, not at all. I was just leaving.
Splendid. Good day.
Ah! Sir!
Finish him. Very prudent of you to have called me before you came here. But stupid of you to have gone at all.
It was nice to meet the people who've been trying to kill you.
Please don't presume I came out of any regard for you.
Expect you to get all choked up about it.
Exactly. If the Fusong is interested in you, it can only be for the same reasons that interest me. I had given you up as a possible clue to the whereabouts of the medallion. It appears I was too hasty.
Good, good.
My hope plans are rejuvenated.
What do you think Danny planned to do with that medallion? Use it himself?
Or sell it to the highest bidder?
You mean to certain interested parties?
Indeed I do. I think in negotiation one might expect to get half a million. Or a knife in the back.
See. Messieurs, mesdames, faites vos jeux. Et rien ne va plus. Sept rouges impérément.
Where do I find him? Up there?
You're out of your mind.
Out of luck.
Ready.
Mesdames, messieurs, faites vos jeux.
Get out of here.
I'll lose half a million? I came here to make a deal. I'm not leaving before I do just that.
You don't know what you're walking into. Please.
I know what I'm doing. Okay, let's play charades. You get this dame off my back and tell Brandon I want to see him.
He wants to see you, too.
Thank you. Messieurs, dames, faites vos jeux.
So talk. I don't like the way the Fusong play. Mm.
So?
So I'm willing to talk a deal with you.
A deal?
You want the medallion?
Yes. And what do you want?
$500,000.
Okay. It's a deal.
Who do you think financed Denny's trip? Who do you think invested in that trinket? I spent time, my own time, finding how and where it could be got. Money and lives, that's what it cost me. It's mine. It belongs to me. Where is it?
I think he's going to be stubborn.
22 noir, pair et pas.
Feel like talking yet, Wilder?
Tell me when. To kill you. Give him the royal tour.
Faites vos jeux.
Something's gone wrong. He's coming in fast.
Too fast.
The Fusong has got Wilder!
Brandy? It is very simple, Mr. Wilder. You have something we want. You will give it to us. It is very simple. Where is the medallion?
It is ours by right. The treasure is Chinese. It belongs to the Chinese people.
In general, or just you two in particular?
You do not understand. It's part of our heritage. It has a holy significance.
Like $10 million. Been out
2 hours, maybe three. Lie still. Someplace else. Any place else.
Airplanes are more practical than dreams.
Airplanes land and people have to get off. What do I do when I get off, Cliff?
Start again? Job, friends. Sooner or later, a man.
Maybe I found one.
Lily, I don't even know what I'm looking for.
$10 million.
Maybe. The last 24 hours, I think I earned a crack at it.
All you earned was a terrible beating. Forget it. Don't risk your life again. Next time, they'll kill you.
I'm not risking anything. I know where the medallion is. They don't.
You still have it?
No.
Then who has?
No one. It's still with Danny. Still think we ought to forget it?
You said we.
That's what I said.
Good morning, dear sir. Mr. Wilder, in trouble again, I see. Come along. Up early, gentlemen. Good morning.
Okay, give the medallion. Only you and I knew where it was, Lily. Remember when I said we?
Don't, Cliff. I love you.
Yeah, you love me. The way you love Danny. You almost put me into his grave. Now, come on, give.
I don't have it. I hid it in the graveyard.
Where in the graveyard?
Under a child's tombstone, next to Danny's grave.
Now, why?
I didn't think you'd want me after you had the money.
So you took out a little insurance.
Oh, Cliff, it's you I want. I don't care about the medallion.
Maybe. Maybe you're telling the truth, Lily, but I can't trust you, not anymore.
Cliff!
I'll be in touch. What's she doing
here?
I know it. Then what's this all about?
Let me talk, please, please.
You know I'm
just
leave
a second.
Now.
Sit down, Brandon. I have brought you here to discuss something. Please sit down. You have achieved nothing but chaos, confusion. You have got under one another's feet. Yet the fortunate stake is so large, there would be more than enough to share. The device of the twin dragons is an ancient symbol of wisdom. Two heads are better than one. I propose an alliance of convenience.
The Fu Song allied to a herd of cheap gangsters.
We're both after the same thing.
But we should have to divide two ways.
Three ways, dear lady.
Why should we cut you in?
My mediator's fee. Also, you won't find the medallion without me. I have information. It's agreed, then? Splendid. It will be a tenuous partnership, but a happy one. Now, my information is that Mr. Wilder no longer has the medallion.
Brilliant, Pinto.
And do you know where he slept last night? In Lily's room. She must be questioned. But unfortunately, my police methods are restricted by certain legalities.
I'll handle her.
No. Leave Lily to me.
Thank you. See what it is.
Official capacity, you understand? In fact, I'm not here at all.
Enough. A straight trade, this for Lily.
Release her. Now you're part of the bargain, Mr. Wilder.
So we have it, then.
Yes, we have it. You can go.
Right now.
But we agreed.
You're not here officially, Pinto. Remember? You're not here at all.
Why did you do it?
Even if there isn't much behind it, I kind of like the way you look.
But they've got everything now.
Not everything. Only the medallion.
You are not happy?
No, I'm not happy.
I'll try something else.
Uh-huh.
Maybe the foot.
Yes, maybe the foot.
Left or right?
It doesn't matter.
Good morning.
It's not a good morning. It's a dreadful morning.
Oh, I don't know. It's a fine day. The sun is shining. The birds are singing.
Not for me. I'm a melancholy man without hopes. A broken blossom tossed upon the stormy waters of fate.
Blossom?
Why didn't you come direct to me? We could have agreed on something. You are a bitter disappointment to me, Mr. Wilder. Bitter disappointment.
You know, I've got a feeling I'm not going to disappoint you.
Huh?
He can make nothing of it.
What do you mean, nothing? He's past it. He's been looking at that thing for 3 days now.
It may take 3 months. I told you before, you must have patience.
Patience? Don't think I'm going to sit here for 3 months while that mumbling old phony plays around. Do you know what? I think he's planning to collect for himself.
The Fusong do not betray their own people.
Funny thing, I just saw Pinto and Wilder together. And another funny thing, Pinto closed the Temple of Bells for repairs.
Beautiful.
Huh. Trinkets, dear lady.
Here.
Are you sure?
Positive. Steps.
Good, good.
We're not there yet.
But nearly, dear sir. Very nearly.
Of the Emperor's tomb throughout all eternity,
or until we came along. You smell it?
Death?
Money, my dear sir. Money.
No, no.
Light?
These were the tilers, the outer guards.
Clear.
Come to weights. Pull them down and...
Easy, the rope's rotten.
There's enough for all of us. More than enough. You can see.
Shut up!
There's only enough for two. That was the deal. But you've served your purpose. Now you can start counting. You've got exactly 10 seconds to say goodbye. And then you'll be guests of Golden Boy over there for a long, long time. First, I'll have that.
Thank you.
No good, we'll never shift him.
You're not just going to sit there, are you?
I've never been addicted to exercise. Besides, if I'm to die, I couldn't have chosen more pleasant surroundings. Like a Viking captain drifting towards Valhalla, his wealth at his feet.
You're full of surprises, Pinto.
The Oriental's philosophy on fate.
Simpler than that. I have never feared death. Only poverty.
Pick up the chest, Pinto. And you too, Lily. You're still working for me.
It's heavy.
Good.
Be generous. We've always helped each other. I've done you many favors.
And very well paid for them, too. If you're lucky, you may just walk out of here alive. Okay, come on.
You wouldn't have got anywhere without me.
Here, Pinto. Here's your share.
Get going. Tricks and Lily gets it first.
It's okay.
You first and watch them. The chest.
Thank you.
Kay?
Yes.
My God, we're in Red China.
Run for it! Come on.
Faster!
They can't follow us here.
Oh, all those jewels. That gold.
That's it. Right back where we started. Well, how'd it feel to be rich for a while?
I never could resist a souvenir.